We had an idea to take our existing technology and what's called repurpose it specifically for the COVID-19 virus particles. In less than 15 minutes, we can tell if they have the disease, and not only that, are they contagious or not, which any other test in the market will not be able to provide at this particular juncture. This isn't the only thing that this test will be able to do. We'll be able to do early cancer detection so they can get proper treatment before they ever get to the hospital. So there's a variety of applications for this same test without changing anything, the hardware for that matter. Our test is so easy. The instrument that we envision is about the size of an iPhone. The chip goes into the instrument, apply the saliva sample, and it provides you an answer. And that's all the operator needs to do. So what that means is that the test could be used at home. Lab on a chip-based devices we've been working on for 20 years, and that's being carried out with colleagues at KU Medical Center. And we've developed quite a bit of infrastructure, equipment and resources here on the KU Lawrence campus to let us do some tests and some development work that no one in the country can do. Every single aspect of this work is being done by graduate students and undergraduate students.
You have to understand how much time and effort is put into these labs, and the graduate students are coming in day in and day out, and Dr. Soper is coming in 24 hours a day and working day and night on this project. And so there's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes.
Developing these little chips here at the cost and the way we build this chip is very unique to KU Lawrence. We have people from all over the world coming here to see how we make chips for a variety of applications. I don't have to outsource things. I can do it all in-house directly here at KU, which just facilitates the speed at which we can deliver results. Scientists care about people. They want to make people's lives better. That's something that's been ingrained in me ever since I was a graduate student here at KU, and I'm trying to do the same for my graduate students too.
Being at home and seeing all the people suffering with this pandemic, it really actually motivated us to come to the lab and then give something back to the society.